You didn't hear what I said. Your obedience is in you accepting Christ's obedience. He obeyed on my behalf. That's why believing the gospel is obeying the gospel. When you believe the gospel, you've obeyed from the heart. Touch somebody's leg, say, it's happening. What Christ has done, we accept it. We receive it. So Romans 5:12, sin entered. Romans 5:20, the law entered. Did you see that? Give me Romans 5:12. Wherefore, by one man, sin entered. Romans 5:20. Moreover, the law entered. So sin entered. After sin entered, the law entered. And sin was not imputed when there is no law. So the law entered that the offense might abound. The law entered that the offense might abound. Romans 3:19. Why did the law enter? For the offense to abound. What will come out of the abounding of the offense? Now we know that what things soever the law saith, it saith to them who are under the law, that every mouth may be stopped and all the world may become guilty before God. Verse 20. Therefore, by the deeds of the law, there shall no flesh be justified in his sight. For by the law is the knowledge of sin. The law came to make everybody guilty, so that every mouth may be stopped. Now let me ask you an intelligent question. Listen to me, everybody in the house. Before the law, was man guilty before God? How many of you say no? Put down your hands. I've seen all of you. How many of you say yes? Lift your hands up. Yes. Let me see all the yeses. Was the world guilty before the law? How are you thinking? Straight, eh? Please think straight. Before the law, was man guilty before God? How many of you say no? How many of you say yes? Okay, yeses are increasing. It's like revelation is beginning to come. Let me repeat one more.